ever wonder what we are, Solomon said there's something in us that initiates our metamorphosis. But more than anything, I think he wanted to be like us, to transform himself, his brother, humanity. He spoke of kindred evolution, said that I was the lock and the key. I wasn't so sure, but now I believe. You know, at first I was jealous of you. I know how that sounds, but I always thought you were Hadern's favorite. He was always checking on you as you slumbered endlessly. You were an easy child, so to speak. But even as you drifted through dreams, you must have thought of him, heard him praying, dreamt of him. Maybe he dreamt of you, too. That day, when Hadern betrayed us, there was no warning. I just felt something break deep below the tower. Stone trembled, crumbling, then shouting. Voices all around me. Some fled, while Solomon begged and pleaded. But Hadern took the others, the seedlings. I tried to protect you, but no attack ever came. I think I'm beginning to understand you. I don't know how, but I think part of Hadern is in you, as much as I am in these stones, and they're in me. Why else are you so human, so alike him? Maybe that's why he spared you and pitied me. through your eyes. It can't be real. Those figures, that thing, it wasn't Solomon. It was only a memory, twisted by fear. We should leave. This place is haunted by the past. The others. I can't believe my eyes. I mean, your eyes. You have a seed of infinity, or at least what's left of one. This may sound odd, but may I have it? Thank you, brother. I shall study it. And in time, I may come to understand what we are, what we can become. You'll see. Have you considered getting good? Thank you. It's incredible. Withered, but not entirely. We could learn much from this little seed. I'll break it apart. See what lies within. Oh, what Solomon would have given to see this. He was certain that ascension was not merely spiritual, but a mechanism of our bodies. Well, we shall see about that. For me? Oh, you spoil me, brother. Let me see. It's beautiful, but empty. Not a drop of nectar left. It's hardened all the way through. Such things, they aren't completely voluntary. At least, that's what Solomon claimed. But who would know better than you and me? This seed, you can almost imagine what it might become. Solomon was certain that there's something inside us, some sacred organ, and that nectar was the proof. Where else could it come from? Thank you, brother. I should tell you, I once asked Solomon to study me, to break me apart, like this seed, and find the sacred organ inside. He refused. Then he said something strange. He asked where I had gotten such an idea. From you, of course, I replied, and he grew very quiet. It's long dead, but thank you. It's not your fault. I had hoped Hadern had failed, but he was thorough. I still don't understand. Why did he do it? Something broke between him and Solomon. I noticed the warning signs, the arguments, the accusation. It was as if he was speaking to another person entirely. What a wonder. This precious little thing. So much potential. I can feel it. Can't you? There's something left. A remnant of nectar. True nectar. What did Solomon once call it? A fragile vessel for the divine. Yes, that's it. Tell me, do you believe we can ascend? As do I, brother. What else can we do but believe? Now, it's time I stretch my wings. Do not worry. I am here. I am everywhere. It's as if a thousand eyes have opened, and I can see through them all. I shall try to wake them, to redeem them, to mend what's broken deep inside. But something else has twisted them. They're more broken than you or I. Please, use those eyes and legs you're so lucky to have.